a girl blunt. I only smoke girl blunt. This shit is a girl blunt. I only smoke girl blunt. This shit is a girl blunt. I only smoke girl blunt. This shit is a girl blunt. I only smoke girl blunt.
Hey guys, so I've been mad cheesy. Like I just love when the camera and the lighting is just whoosh. Like, you see my face? Like, my face looks so clear, my eyebrows look shit happen. Like, but what's good, cheesy gang? I'm back with another video. Okay, back with another video, y'all. Trying to get them back to back, you feel me? Nah, so as you guys can see in the title, this video today, it's gonna be a girl talk video, okay? It's gonna be a girl talk video about periods. But yeah, so today we're gonna have a girl talk video. It's gonna be about all the little stuff, little nasty stuff, I guess, little good stuff, bad stuff about girls that can make or break your life, okay? That can help you. It could be some pros or cons, whatever you wanna call it. Most of these are gonna be like a lot of period hacks, I guess. Or a lot of period tips. I might add in or mix in some like feminine hygiene tips or whatever, or stuff that I've learned just from watching like other YouTubers or hearing other people's tips about feminine hygiene. Okay, you guys, I'm gonna really try to take my time while I talk so I don't forget things that I have to say, and so I can get my thoughts out without like stuttering. Okay, you guys, so you guys can understand me, okay? So yeah, I hope you guys like this video and stay tuned for more. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my video and to my channel, you guys. Don't forget to share with others, okay? Comment down below what other videos you guys wanna see, okay? Go follow my Instagram at Miss Cheesy, sorry y'all, and my Snapchat at sweet_melanin, okay? And don't forget to like my last video that I've posted if you guys didn't see it, all right? So let's get into the video. All right, I'm done chatting. All right, hold on. Okay, so first of all, we're gonna say some facts. Maybe facts, most of them are facts. Most of them are facts, maybe it might not be true for you, but most of them are facts. So girls usually get their periods in between the ages of 8 and 15 years old in the US, okay? So how old was I when I had my period? That was like almost 10 years ago. That was almost 10 years ago. So that means I was like 11-ish, 12-ish. That was like 7th grade. Yes! That was like 7th grade, you guys. 6th grade, 7th grade, I think I got my period. Maybe it's TMI, I don't know. But if you don't want to watch it, don't watch it. I mean, I'm not, let me not say that. But it's my video and it's my channel. Let's talk about what I want to talk about, period. Okay, so yeah, so that's what I'm going to talk about. So yeah, I think I got my period when I was like in 7th grade. I remember my mom like took, she made a whole big thing. She took us out. She took me out for brunch or whatever. We went out to Red Lobster or whatever. Cause I'm a woman now. I hate that term. Like, I think I just hate the term of period in general. I just don't like it. I'm not saying hate, I just don't like it. And I'm like, I don't know, I'm very like cringy, or like stuff crawl my skin a lot. Certain words crawl my skin a lot with it being used. And I just, don't say it. Don't say it around me. But yeah, so yeah, same thing. She did that for my other siblings too. Like, well, yeah. So, but yeah, so we went out, whatever, made a whole big thing about it. Whoop-de-doo, blood, that's all. So, what is a period? A period is basically the shedding of your uterus lining, right? So, every month, your body's getting prepared to have a baby, basically, or fertilize the egg. So, that's why you're like, you're basically cleaning out all the nasty blood, all the old blood, dirty blood, or like getting your body ready to fertilize. So obviously if you get pregnant, then your period stops or pauses, because that blood is going to be used for like nutrients for a baby, right? So basically when you get your period, you're able to have babies, so you're able to get pregnant, basically, if you're a little young and who didn't know. Okay, all right. So the tools to use, like obviously tools, materials that can be used while having a period, is pads. Obviously people call them sanitary napkins, I guess. That's a kind of weird name for it, but you can use pads, pants you can use, tampons you can use, menstrual cups, menstrual disc. Okay, I never used those, but I heard that it works good. I heard that it's great. It's supposed to last like up to 12 hours or something like that. Me specifically, I don't know, like, me specifically, I'm not trying to be pulling out a day's full worth of blood. I'm weak over here. Yeah, over here, look at that. But yeah, I'm not trying to be putting out no day's worth or how much hours worth of blood and seeing that build up. Like, that's nasty. A pad is already nasty enough. A tampon is already nasty enough, right? Tampons are usually, the directions is usually, it says up to 6 to 8 hours. And pads around the same thing, 4 to 6 hours, maybe. So let me tell you guys, my story. First of all, I wear pads and tampons. I don't wear menstrual discs or cups. I don't mind. I wanting to try them in the future, being that, like, I just want to make sure I'm more knowledgeable about them, because I have to use, like, natural things. It's good to use natural things only down there, you guys, to decrease the amount of incidents and messing up your pH balance. You don't want that. So I had to play the hard. I had to learn the hard way. So basically, I use pads and tampons. I use the overnight pads, Kotex brand. And that's too much information. Like, I don't know. I use overnight pads because you obviously can have a heavy flow and a light flow, heavy flow. I have a heavy flow, and I'm not wearing. People be coming with these little skimp shits, and I'm just like laughing because this is a joke. This is a joke, right? So I would have to, like, I would put in a tampon and put on a pad, because if I don't, it's clipped for me, y'all. It's clipped. Yo, when I saw this post, it was like, well, bend me, what is that? Well, bend me in half and paint me silver, because it's clipped for me. It's clipped for me, niggas. I don't know who posted that shit, but I was weak, okay? But no, really, it's clipped for me. It's clipped for me. It's clipped for my underwear. It's clipped for my bed. It's clipped for me, period. That's it. So, yeah. So I would have to wear both, and I would put on, like, a tight shorts or something on top of that to keep everything in place, because, you know, sometimes, y'all know, y'all girls know, like, the pad will move and that shit will slip out of place sometimes and fuck up your whole shit. So that's another tip. You guys can wear, like, shorts with your pads or whatever, with your underwear, to keep it in place, obviously, right? So yeah, so that's what I do. I wear overnight everything until it's time. Like, only, like, when I start to get more knowledgeable and more things about my period or about my body itself, then I would know, like, then I would be like, oh, let me get a smaller size than this, or this certain size for when it's lighter, obviously. I used to just put it in whatever, or I only started wearing tampons recently, like a couple of years now, to be honest with you, and that's the best thing that ever happened to my life, I swear to God, because I was fucking up everything. With just the pad, I was fucking up my bed, I was fucking up my sheets, I was fucking up my underwear, everything was getting fucked up, like, period, that's it. You guys, I have a story time. Yo, comment down below if you guys want to hear this badass period story time, okay? Comment down below. But yeah, you already know what I'm talking about. So comment down below. But yeah, so those are the tools that you can use. So those are the tools that you can use. How many hours a day to wear them? I already went through that, 4 to 6 hours, up to 8 hours max. 8 hours max, that should be the max amount of time that you're wearing something. And to be honest with you, your shit is light if you're wearing it for a full 8 hours straight, because I can't do that. So if you guys can do that, that's great for you guys. I'm so happy for you guys. But also beware of toxic shock syndrome. Yeah, I think so. You get that from, like, tampons. So if you wear it too long in a day, it's gonna fuck you up. So don't do that. And it's fatal, you guys. So don't do that. Doubling pads. That was another tip that I learned about. Doubling pads. A lot of people double them. Basically, they have one pad, put it on, and then they put another pad on top of it. So basically, when that first pad is full, instead of having to go in your bag and find a pad, sneak it out, trying to be low key or whatever, you just go to the bathroom, pull off that pad that's full, throw that away, and you have a nice, fresh, clean pad right there, and you could just put a pant in and go. I personally have never done this, just because I feel like if I do that, I'm gonna end up with the type of pads. Like, I've just now started finding pads that can hold a lot but are still thin. But before, like, that couldn't work for me, because I'm not walking around with this much thickness of pad in between my legs. on a regular day. Like, who's doing that? That's just gonna hurt. Like, no, I'm not doing that. So no, nah. Yeah, so that's another way that you could double it. One way that I do to double pads sometimes is to do it, or like pads or panty liners, because sometimes, you know, that should just be fucking, it be like they got wings and the wings don't do nothing for you. It don't do nothing for you. You still end up with blood fucking on your panties and your shorts and your pants. Like, it don't do nothing. So let's try to listen to the tip, okay? Okay. But what I do is basically put one pad on the left side, put one pad on the right side of the middle part of your underwear, obviously where it's supposed to go. And then like make sure like the other halves are like, those two can overlap in the middle, right? So you have like a nice thick pad that's thick horizontally, that's enough space, right? So nothing will be spilling over. I hope I explained that properly for you guys. If I didn't, just ask me again, I guess, and I'll try to take my time in another video to clear it for you guys. So yeah. All right, establishing your period panties. What panties are you gonna wear on your period? So basically what you could do is granny panties. Like, I don't know, who doesn't know about that, obviously. Wear your granny panties, or buy a pack of granny panties, buy a pack of fucking Hanes or Fruit of the Loom underwear. Garbage panties that you don't care about, that you're not gonna fucking care about, right? You don't wanna mess up your fucking sexy thongs. You don't wanna mess up your sexy lace panties, that man thing and thing, right? So buy some baggy panties, buy some baggy real quick and put them on. That's it. So yeah, so, and preferably another tip, you guys, dark colors. You guys already know dark colors. Obviously, if you have your period, dark pants, black, brown. I don't know if you want to wear brown, but I just stick to black and maybe like dark blues and just a lot of tights, a lot of layering, you guys. That's what I do. I layer my clothes a lot because I just don't trust that shit, y'all. I just don't trust that shit, and that shit will fuck you up on a good day, you feel me? And I don't have time. So yeah, dark colors, they hold in the blood. You feel me? They hold in the blood. If you wear a light fucking underwear, that shit is gonna stain your panties. That shit is never gonna wash off. And you're just gonna be fucked. You're gonna be fucked, you guys. I gotta stop cursing. All right. Well, another thing, period travel packs, right? So one thing that I always did since middle school was have like a little purse or a little something, a little clutch. I don't have anything around me right now that I can use for example. But you guys know, like a little something, a little small purse that you guys, all girls walk around with, small little purse in their bag. A small little clutch that they put like little hand lotion, little body sprays, little something, little pads, little tampons, stuff like that. Put in your, keep in there. So if you gotta go to the bathroom, you gotta run to the bathroom or something, you already know, you bring your purse with you, you got your pads, you put like a little 2-3 pads in there, 2-3 tampons, some wipes maybe, an extra pair of underwear, if in case you mess up your, you mess yourself up, you know? That's all right. A little spray, a little feminine spray, product spray, whatever, I don't know. Not something that to spray down in your underwear to mess up your pH balance, but you know, something for uplift you a little bit, a little something. So yeah. Another tip, you guys, is a period tracker or like a period calendar app or something. The app that I have is PC, P.C. I'm gonna show y'all. Oh fuck. It's PC. That right there, if it would focus. That's the app. This is the app. You can basically see your calendar. You can see your calendar. It shows you can track when you start your period, when your period ends. It tracks when you start ovulation, your low chances of getting pregnant, your medium chances of getting pregnant, and your higher chances of getting pregnant. Let you know when you miss it. So I just started using this app, to be honest with you, since like for like the my previous period. So I don't know. I'll let you guys know on if it's exactly accurate for my future video or something. So yeah, it lets you know like your ovulation days. But not for sure on all of that. But y'all get the point, right? Alright. Alright, y'all. Next is sex on periods. Is that a myth or a fact, and do I do it? I'm not having sex on my period. Period. I'm not having sex on my period. I will never. Because first of all, people do it. Alright, it's not a myth. People do it. And some people, I heard that like it makes it better, like, or it helps like your period, it helps with cramps. I'm not with it. Cause first of all, imagine cramps on your first, second day of period. cramps, I kill you, kill me belly, I kill me belly. And you wanna put dick in you? Like, you gonna, I don't know, like, I mean, I talk too much, but that's just gonna hurt. Like, and your uterus is right there, like, that's just gonna hurt, I feel like, and I don't know about y'all, but I don't have time for the, like, nicey-nicey business thing, and I don't have time, so I don't do it, and I won't do it ever. And that's just messy. That's messy, and that's dirty. Your bed is gonna look crazy. You might as well put a fucking wee-wee pad underneath you to fucking mess up on, because that's crazy, and your man is nasty if you wanna do that. Would you ever do that? I would never do that. My boyfriend, it's not even a question. He would never do it, because we picky as fuck, and that shit is nasty, period. Using a heating pad, obviously, you guys, for cramps, I use a heating pad. I ordered my heating pad off of Amazon. I don't have it here, you guys. My sister took it, and I don't know where she put it, but it's here somewhere, and I'm not looking for it, because I don't know where she put it, and I'm not going home. But, yeah. But heating pad, the one that I have, it's from Amazon. If you guys type in heating pad, it'll probably be, like, the first one that pops up. It's basically, like, a hard plastic type of canteen container thing, and you could boil water or put regular water, freeze it, or use boiling water, obviously. I usually boil water, pour it in there, you squeeze out the excess air, and you lock it, and then you put your sock thing over it, back up, you good. And it's, like, so warm. It lasts for, like, 5-6 hours. Like, it's valid, you guys, it's valid. Like, listen to me and go order it. It was only, like, $11, so, to be honest, like, $8 to $11. It wasn't expensive. It took me a while to get it, because I was being cheap, and I am a cheap person. But it wasn't expensive. I just didn't want to pay for shipping. That's the only thing. But don't pay me no mind, you guys. What pills do I use? I use Motrin. I need the 800 Motrins. Okay, you guys. I don't know about y'all. But I need 800 Motrins. Okay. Other than that, I'm fucked, you guys. Fucked. Them 200s, you got to be popping like three, four of them. Because it's just not working out. But next, people be using like Advil and Excedrin, I think, but I don't use that. I just use Motrin because I don't got time to be mixing up pills, and I don't got time for all that shit. So, another thing that I've learned or I've heard from somebody from YouTube is look better, feel better. So basically, that means is you wake up out of your bed, you got your period, you wake up out of your bed with sweatpants on, you're just upset, you're just mad, you're just down and depressed with the world. Lift yourself up, man. Lift yourself up. I'm mad annoying me. Lift yourself up though, make yourself look nice, you know, go take a shower, go do your hair, go do some makeup. Make yourself look pretty to feel better, you know, to look pretty. The way, if you look pretty, you're gonna feel better. Me, like, I look pretty today, I feel like, you know, I'm glowing, you already know. I don't have my period, but you know, I look pretty, and I wanna make sure people see me, I wanna make sure people, like, I pop out, should pop out. It looks nice, it feels nice, I feel good, you know. That's, do that, you know. I'm gonna try to take that more into consideration. I've started to do that, and it actually does work. Like, you still gonna feel like cramps, sis. You still gonna feel the cramps, but it helps. It does help. Okay, so try it and let me know, you guys, if it does work. Eat foods that benefits you during that time of the month. So basically, you wanna eat junk food all the time for that whole week or whatever. But you know, like, let's switch it up, let's mix it out, let's eat some healthy stuff, some stuff that can help you build iron, being that you're losing all that blood, some stuff that can give you some glucose, some sugar. Dark chocolate is good for you if you want to eat something sweet. Dark chocolate is more preferable to eat on your period, I guess, because it was rich also. But yeah, those, for example, that's a whole list of stuff. I'm not gonna list out everything, but yeah, I'm anemic, and iron will be good. So, like, for example, I would eat, like, a lot of kale and a lot of spinach. Do I eat a lot of kale and a lot of spinach? Do I take my iron pills like I should? No, I don't, you guys. No, I don't. And I'm the worst example for you guys, but don't be like me. Don't be like me, okay? Do better, dude. Don't be like me. So, okay, so here's a hack, you guys. Here's a tip/hack. And this is gonna be, we're almost done. So here's a tip/hack. If you guys end up getting your period in the blue, out of the blue, in the middle of the day, what are you gonna do? What are we gonna do? I don't know. I know for sure I'm not the only one who does this. Because I saw other people, other YouTubers talking about this too. making a fake pad. So you basically take some tissue, a little bit of tissue, fold that in half, fold that in half again, until you can make one look a nice little panty liner looking thing, or a nice little like pad, nice to hold it enough until you could find the pad. In the meantime, ask a friend to borrow something that look a tampon or look a pad or something. Use that real quick, put it in the middle part of your panty, and you're good. That now is no, listen sis, that could probably hold you for 5 minutes, that could hold you for 25 minutes, okay? So let's do this and let's think, let's be realistic, okay? Don't say if it went through, don't blame me, all right? Because I told you what the consequences were, all right? Last but not least, you guys, the last and final tip, you guys, water. Okay, water, like, that's the best thing. Apparently, you guys, I learned that we're not supposed to have cramps. Like, if you guys eat healthy enough, you're not supposed to have cramps on your period. You're not supposed to, like, be hurting on your period. So, like, you guys need to drink water. I need to drink water. Like, I always drink water, to be honest with you. But why not spread it? Like, drink water, you guys. That should help, and that should decrease your cramps as well. Make your period be nice and smooth. And just try to drink enough water throughout that week, or however long your period lasts, to help. You wanna end up with a clean face. You know, people break out already. You want your face to be clean. You wanna end up, you wanna start with a good period, you wanna end with a good period, all right? You don't wanna be fucked up at the end, all right? But yeah, comment down below, you guys. That's all for this video about our feminine/period tips or hacks, you guys. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know what other videos you guys wanna see. Okay, don't forget to comment down below what you guys think about this video. Alright, how my hair look. And let me know, you guys, if you guys want to see other girl talk videos, okay? I love you guys, and I thank you so much for watching my video and sharing it with others, okay? Don't forget to click that bell. Love y'all. Later.
That booty, ooh, she jiggle like a jelly roll.
Damn.
Chocolate, I'm looking edible.